Lavina, that is yours.
Go.
Okay, thank you, Anga. Good morning, Babe. I will explain about the history of natural approach. Tracy Taylor, a teacher of Spanish in California, applied a professional for the new philosophy of language teaching, which called the natural approach. And this was an attempt to develop a language teaching proposal that incorporated the naturalistic participle of researchers had identified in the study of second language acquisition. The natural approach grew out of Taylor's experience teaching Spanish class. Since that time, Taylor and others have experimented with implementing the natural approach in elementary to advanced level class and with several other languages. At the same time, he has joined course with Stephen Crescent and applied linguistics at the University of Southern California in elaborating a theoretical rationale for the natural approach, drawing on Crescent's influential theory of second language acquisition. Crescent and Taylor combined a statement of the past principles and practice of the natural approach appears in the book The Natural Approach, published in 1983. The natural approach has attracted a wider interest than some of the other innovative language teaching proposal discussed in this book. Technically, because of its support by Crescent and Taylor's books contain theoretical section prepared by Crescent that outline his view on second language acquisition and section on implementation and class productions prepared largely by Taylor. Thank you. The next presentation will be explained by Afisha.
Good morning, baby. I am Afisha Ramawati. I will explain about theory of language. Unlike with audio-lingual method, which use grammar as the central component of language, this method see the communication as the primary function of language. Language is essential for communicating message and meanings. And acquisition can take place only when people understand message in the target language. So this method emphasizes on comprehensible input, distinguishing between acquisition as natural conscious process and learning as conscious process. In the last, grammatical structure does not require explicit analysis or attention by the language teacher or by the language learner and in the language teaching materials. That's all from me. And then about theory of language learning by Angela Mariani. Thank you.
Good morning, Babe and friends. I explain about theory of learning. Crescent and Taylor make containing reference to the theoretical and research-based claim to underlie the natural approach and the fact that the method is unique in having such a base. It is based on an empirically ground theory of second language acquisition. which has been supported by a large number of scientific studies in a wide variety of language acquisition and learning contexts. The theory and research are grounded on Gresham's view of language acquisition, which we will collectively refer to as Gresham's language acquisition theory. Gresham's view have been presented and discussed extensively elsewhere, so we will not try to present or critique Gresham's argument here.
Okay, good morning, Babe. Good morning, my friends. Here, I would like to tell you about the objectives. Then, the natural approach is for beginners and is designed to help them become intermediate. And it has the expectation that students will be able to function adequately in the target situation, and they will understand the speakers of the target language, like perhaps with requests for clarification, and will be able to convey like in a non-insulting manner, and then request and ideas, and then they need to know every word in a particular semantic dominant, nor is it necessary that the semantic and vocabulary be flawless, but their production doesn't need to be understood. They should be able to make the meaning clear, but not necessarily be accurate in all details of grammar. And then, however, since the natural approach is offered a general set of principles applicable to a wide variety of situations, as in communicate language teaching specific objectives and listening or speaking. And upon being taught present in the general field, it is important to communicate to learners what they can expect of a course, as well as what they should not expect. And then they offer us an example, possible goal and noble statement for a beginning natural approach Spanish class. After that, after 100 until 115 hours of natural approach Spanish, you will be able to get around in Spanish, like you will be able to communicate with a monolingual native speakers of Spanish without difficulty, read most ordinary text in Spanish with some use of a dictionary, like know enough Spanish to continue to improve on your own. After 100 until 150 hours of natural approach Spanish, you will not be able like pass for a native speaker use Spanish as easily as you use English, understand native level 2. And then I'm not be able to immerse the drop successfully. So use Spanish on the telephone with great comfort, participate easily in a conversation with several other native speakers on unfamiliar topics. creator is seen as a process of comprehensive total information. The apparatus is challenged by input data. Input is slightly beyond his or her current level of competence and is able to assign meaning to the input. Next,
listening to lecture, and the last, academic learning skills, writing, taking notes in the class.
Of this, they note that the natural approach is primarily designed to develop basic communication skills, both oral and written. They then observe that communication goals may be expressed in terms of situations, functions, and topics, and proceed to order four pages of topics and situations, which are likely to be most useful to beginning students. The functions are not specified or suggested, but are felt to derive naturally from the topics and situation. This approach to syllabus design would appear to derive to some extent from their salt level specifications. And the second point of view holds that the purpose of the language course will vary according to the needs of the students and their particular interests. The goals of a natural approach class are based on assessment of students' needs. We determine the situations in which they will use the target language and the sorts of topics they will have to communicate information about. In setting communication goals, we don't expect the students at the end of a particular course to have acquired a contained group of structures or forms. Instead, we expect them to deal with a particular set of topics in a given situation. We don't organize the activities of the class about the grammatical syllabus. From this point of view, it is difficult to specify communicative goals that necessarily fit the needs of all students. Thus, any list of topics and situations must be understood as syllabus suggestions rather than as specifications.
Okay, good morning, ma'am. This procedure is about natural approach. And procedures, the first brainstorming or discussion to establish the vocabulary and expression to be used to accomplish the communicative intent, include a framework or means of structuring a conversation or exchange to achieve the purpose of the speakers. And the second is about question and answer based on the dialogue topic and the situation, such as invested, very question, yes or no, error, and